Thank you for coming on the show.
Oh, my God. I love it.
I'm very lucky that I got to hang out with you a little bit this summer.
We did.
Yeah, and we went to this fishing thing in Idaho, yeah. And your daughter was there,
yeah,
Alice?
She's here. Where's Alice? I let her play hooky. There she is.
Hey, Alice, hi!
Don't tell any other...
Oh, yeah. So
late night guys.
No.
But she insisted on coming to this one.
Oh, she did?
She's never...
I won't tell any of the other
Don't
late night guys.
Don't tell the other late night
No,
guys.
I won't. Yeah. We bonded over Taylor Swift. Yeah.
They have...
That's an easy way to get an applause.
Yeah. They had like a 40-minute conversation about Taylor Swift. It was incredible. It was incredible.
I think she was on her way to her second... Is that possible?
Yeah.
I was like, how lucky are you? You're going to see her twice. That's so rad.
Yes,
yeah.
Exactly. And I took a picture of you and Jimmy. You were about to go fishing. Do you have it?
Do you have
the picture? Yeah, it is. This is the picture I took of Jimmy and Jimmy. Jimmy Fallon and Jimmy Kimmel.
Yeah.
About to go fishing.
We actually went fishing together. Look at us.
And you are laughing because everything you have on is fishing gear. Some of it you didn't even know existed, like the neck wrap.
No, I bought everything out of the gift shop, and I was like, yeah, I'm ready to fish. Clearly, you've never been fishing before. Kimmel was like, why do I hang out with this guy? It's unbelievable. I want to ask you a question, by the way.
Yes.
Did you ever think that this guy here was going to be CNN's chief Washington correspondent one day?
That's me.
I was 18 years old. My friend Daryl, this is Daryl's 18th birthday party. This is October 1987.
Wow.
October 19th.
And did you want to be a journalist?
No, actually, I wanted to be a cartoonist. I did a comic strip for the school paper. I wanted to be the next, like, Gary Trudeau, do Doonesbury, something like that. That was my goal, but it did not work out. I ended up okay.
Yeah, I think you ended up pretty good, yeah. Would you ever do a cartoon series or a cartoon strip or a comic?
I think I would, theoretically, but I do drawings here and there when I can. I did a T-shirt design for Dave Matthews. We haven't shown these yet. I designed a shirt where the Dave Matthews Band, this is with their permission, is a set of superheroes called the Devengers. And we're selling
Dave Matthews, the Devengers.
Yes, and so I drew and designed this, and the Dave Matthews Band is going to start selling them tonight.
It's a cool T-shirt.
And proceeds go to help wounded veterans. And you go to DaveMatthewsBand.com.
You have the first one. You have the very first one. You can keep this up.
That's fantastic.
This is the first one.
I appreciate this. Yeah. You're a talented guy.
Thank you.
I also have your books as well. Let's go back to how kind of people really know you. You're on CNN.
Yes.
This is a big deal. You did Super Tuesday. That was last night.
It was.
Yeah, and the results were ultimately what we thought, right?
Yes, Biden and Trump will be... facing off. If you like reruns, you get you get it. You get your rerun.
Exactly.
Well, our generation was raised on reruns, right? We watched a lot of MASH at like 7 and 7:30. And
Is it hard to cover that when you just know what the story, what the ending kind of is, or do you?
Every now and then voters will throw a curveball, and like you don't know what actually is going to happen.
Yeah.
But last night we knew what was going to happen.
Yeah, you knew.
It's not hard because voters do offer you surprises sometimes, but this was not surprising.
No. And then we have State of the Union coverage
tomorrow. Tomorrow night. Big opportunity for President
Biden. What number is this for you, State of the Union for you?
I think this is maybe the 25th that I've covered, the 25th
That's
of them.
Amazing, buddy. Yeah. Congratulations. That's amazing, bud.
That's
so cool.
They're very long.
That's so cool that
very long.
This kid, a freshman right here, is doing this 25th State of the Union. I mean,
you have the
on.
Best researchers. I think I posted this on Facebook like 10 years ago.
Yeah, that's us. Yeah, exactly. We liked it. We liked it.
I'm going to have
to... Follow him.
I'm going to have to block you.
Like his... What do we expect from President Biden tomorrow night?
Well, he's hoping...
Yes.
To present his case. The economy's doing better. He's going to have probably some bad guys to go after, such as he's going after companies for shrinking, like the size of cookies and stuff like that. Did you see this? Shrinkflation? Like, you pay the same, but the Oreos are smaller.
Oh, yeah, I know what shrinkflation is.
You know what shrinkflation is? No, I don't mean that.
All too well.
I'm not referring.
All too well.
I was in the pool.
Yeah, exactly. Right.
No. But Cookie Monster weighed in on this. Did you see this? Cookie Monster on Twitter said something in opposition to shrinkflation.
I did see that.
It's true. And Frank Oz, who's an original Muppeteer, he was the voice of Miss Piggy and Yoda, he got mad. He went on Twitter and said, like, Cookie Monster should not be entering the political debate.
This really happens.
He's got a point there.
No,
yeah.
I understand.
But is Biden going to talk about? Because one thing I would do, if I would, of course I'm not advising the president, but I see all these headlines that the stock markets are breaking these records and it's the highest they've ever been, and I go, well, no one's really talking about this.
Who's talking about it actually? Donald Trump last night talked about it, except he took credit for it. He said it's because Wall Street thinks he's going to be elected again in November, so the stock market is now going up because of him.
Oh, is that right?
Yeah.
That's why it's up? That's so good.
Well, you got to give him...
That's so good.
Points for creativity. Yeah. I would assume that Biden is going to talk about some of the good economic news while also acknowledging that, you know, food prices and rent are still too high, and he's still talking about that. The big challenge, then, I think, for him and obviously for... what Republicans are hoping he does is that he doesn't make any big mistakes, because a lot of people are paying attention to his age and concerned about his age. I've been covering him for 25 years, and this is a guy who, even when he was, like, you know, youngish, was gaffe-prone and long-winded, and, like, you know, even then...
He was in his 50s.
Right, even then, it would be like an open question, can he get through an hour speech without stepping in it? And now he's 81, so... But last year, he had a really good moment, actually. Last year, he had a moment where, like, somebody heckled him on Social Security. He was saying the Republicans were going to raise or cut Social Security, Medicare, and they booed him. And he said, oh, so he did a pivot. Like, you agree with me now. Great, we're making progress. Something like that.
Oh, that's good.
So he had a moment. But, you know, I got to imagine they're nervous at the White House right now and that they're salivating at the Republican National Committee, hoping for a mistake.
I want to talk about the United States of...
Oh, yeah.
This is the United States of Scandal.
Yes.
This is a six-part series. I think it's genius, by
Thank
the way.
You so much. Just so you know, it's not airing this Sunday because of the Oscars, but the next Sunday it's coming on.
No. And this Sunday, watch Jimmy Kimmel.
Right, well...
Jimmy Kimmel, yeah.
He's our boy.
Yeah, right? We watch Jimmy Kimmel. Yeah, we like him.
But the Sunday after that, we're going to do McGreevy. These are... You know, a lot of things changed when Donald Trump came down that escalator in 2015. And we went back and looked at some of the scandals that were so huge before then. Sanford and John Edwards and Blagojevich and Spitzer interviewed major players in them, sat down with them, tried to figure out what really happened. And it's been fun. It's really fascinating.
It's all fascinating stuff. Congrats on this. I want to show a clip. Here's Jake Tapper with former Governor Jim McGreevy in the next episode of United States of Scandal. Take a look at this.
I didn't wake up and say, you know, I'm going to be deceptive for the sake of deceiving. I'm going to create this whole double ledger. No. I didn't make that decision prior to a gubernatorial campaign. I made it, like, at 7 or 8 years old. I can remember this as if it were yesterday. I go to my local public library, and I'm pulling out the card catalog, looking for the word homosexuality, and it said underneath, see psychiatric illness. And it was just like, whew, this thing, at least then in America, called gay, wasn't a good thing. I realized at that point in time that life is going to be a very painful trajectory if I own this. And you just try to make an accommodation, albeit an unhealthy accommodation.
Oof. Jake Tapper, everybody.
Thank you.
You're so good.
Thank you, sir.
You're so good.
It's great to be here.
United States of Scandal airs on CNN Sunday nights at 9 p.m. We'll be right back with a performance from Norah Jones. Stick around, everybody. Hey, hey.